Hey everyone, today we're going to turn this into poof. Oh yeah, we're going to turn everything into these. Now let's go to the table and show you how it's done. Okay everyone, so today we are making featured books. And how, you ask? Well, we're going to take all these books. To learn how to make these books, I suggest you go to the DMG Info's YouTube page. He has a dungeon build playlist that is epic, for one, and he teaches you how to make these books. Now, his books are approximately one popsicle width, which is 1 centimeter, by 7 millimeters across. So the height is 1 centimeter, the width of the book is 7 millimeters, and there's closed books, now I made some partially open books where the cover is kind of up, and then you'll see here's some, an open book, so you can make all those. Now, the dimensions on the larger books, which are for the D&D books, or if you have a larger spell book or something like that that you want to make, these are one popsicle width, which is 1 centimeter, so that's this way in width. The height is 1.5 centimeters. Okay, so that's going up and down here along the spine. So that's the size of those. And these are all ready to go. So let's go to the computer and I'll show you how to make the covers, or at least prep the covers, and then we're gonna add them to the books and show you how I make the pages for the inside as well at the same time. I'm also going to show you how I made my scrolls and maps, kind of as a little bonus, and the open Necronomicon book. All right, so let's go to the computer and do that. Okay, everyone, so this is the computer portion of the tutorial here, and I'm going to do the best I can. I don't have a screen recorder, so just bear with me. Looks like everything's coming out pretty darn clear. Okay, so the first thing you're going to need is WordPad. And this usually comes pretty standard on every computer that has Microsoft Windows. So, if you want to do a search for it, just go to your search menu, type in WordPad, and it should be the first one up there. Oops. See? It's hard to do one-handed. There it is again. So I'm going to hit that. Okay, so this is where we're going to put all of our image files. And shrink them down to size and get them ready to print. Well, where do you get the image files? Very simple. Okay. You're going to go to Internet Explorer or your favorite web browser. I know a lot of people have issues with Explorer. They use Firefox, any web browser is fine. I don't have any issues with Explorer, so I'm going to continue to keep going here. And then type in whatever you're looking for. So if you're looking for, let's see, book covers. All right, so type in what you want to find. Go to images, and boom. So you're going to get all different kinds. If you're looking for a specific one, just make sure you type it into the search, and it should bring it up pretty much right away. So all you have to do, I'll just find one here. So here's the cover for the Monster Manual, and usually there's different versions of it. So I prefer this image of this, and down here will be an image that's similar to the one I just pulled up. So I like this better than the other one. I think the other one was actually a picture of a book, where this is the actual image, so it's got better quality. So when you find the image you like, go to View Image. Should bring it up all by itself. And sometimes you can blow it up even bigger if it allows you. Then you're just going to save the image as. Okay. Save it to where you want to save it. I've already done so. I actually made a folder which has all the book covers. It's got some of the games that I made. I've even got some Goosebumps covers. These here are all pages from different books. This is like the Lovecraftian Necronomicon. Also, if we stretch the image, you can turn it into a scroll. And let me give you an example of how to search for those. So I'm going to exit out of this. I already have this image saved, so I don't need it. I was just kind of showing you what to do. So you're going to build up your collection. I'm going to go now and do, scroll spells. Scroll spells. Should come up. Don't make me spell it all the way out. I'm lazy. Spell a little. And then you may get a random thing like this. It took me a little while to find actual, like, scroll looking things. Yeah, these aren't going to do it. So, to be honest, I forgot exactly what I typed in. I think I typed in something to do with spells. Spell. Sorry if I'm getting a little crazy with the angle. Spellbook pages. Let's see what that brings up. Okay, here we go. This is a little bit better. Remember, if you stretch it, it will look like a scroll. If it's something you really like this awakening spell could be turned into a scroll. This one wasn't here last time. That one's kind of cool. So, and then there's ones over here with elements, and then you got real magic, you got printable spell books, you got Book of Shadows, Harry Potter, blank ones, printables. So, and the list just goes on and 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 on. Now, you're probably asking yourself, okay, well, that's great. I've got all the book covers I want. I've got all these spell book pages. I've got all the scrolls that I want. And the other thing would be maps. Okay, so you want to look up, let's just say, I can't even spell either. I'm sorry. Forgotten Realms maps. There we go. Okay. So the same thing here applies, and you can do look up D&D maps. You can look up Neverwinter or Keep on Shadowfell or whatever campaign you're doing, Horde of the Dragon Queen. And look, there's even Sword Coast up here. Underdark, 4E, and the list goes on and on. Find one you like, and you're going to save that file. You can either save it in the same folder, or you could create a different folder for specifically maps, which I have done, and we'll show you in just a few minutes. So, this one's actually kind of cool. Looking, so I'm going to do the same thing that I did with the book covers. Blow it up, and then I'm going to save the picture. And see right here, I have a folder named D&D Maps. And I have several folders of mine. I don't happen to have this one, so I'm just going to toss it in here. Just because it looks cool. I like the style of it. And that's kind of what you're going to look for when you do all this. Now, once you've got all that filled out, you've got a stockpile of stuff, let's go start putting this stuff together so we can actually add it to our books. Alright, so you're going to open up your word pad. It should be nice and blank. And the ruler up here is fairly accurate. I did do kind of a test and everything lines up pretty darn perfectly. So it could be a different case for you if you have a tiny monitor. There's other programs out there that you can use. I use this because, one, it's free and it already comes with Microsoft. So you don't technically have to buy any other software or download anything. It is what it is. So let me show you how to get this stuff ready. And we're going to insert a picture. There it goes. All right. So then you just go to wherever you saved it. You can save it to your desktop or specific folder. And book covers right here. All right. Oh, there you have it. So you just scroll through, find the book covers you want. Let's start with the Dungeon Master's Guide. Alright, so obviously this is way too big. If you print it out, it's not going to fit on your miniature books. So just grab and move the corner. It's that easy. Okay, you're going to make sure you're at the top of the page. And then you're going to keep shrinking it down. Now, that looks roughly about right, but we're going to double check it. So, I have my bucket of books here that we made. And I'm just going to grab one. Doesn't matter what color it is, because you're just going to use it for size. And this might seem like a really ridiculous way of doing this, but it works. So, I'm going to hold the book up there. And I don't know if you guys can see, but it does need to be shrunk down a bit more. And this looks silly, but it actually works. Like I said, the ruler there is pretty accurate. Okay. So now I'm going to double check it. And we can make that a little bit bigger. I kind of went a little too small there. So, and if you go over the size a little bit, it's not a big deal. And you can see I can go wider. I think the height is about right. Because you can always trim a little bit of it. Ooh, there. So you're just going to play with it until you get it the right. Okay, so it looks like we got a good width. Got a good height. Okay, so then that sets the standard for all the other D&D books. So I usually space about 3 spaces apart. And then I'm going to add in another one. Let's say we want the player's handbook. If you're doing a gamer's, game master's desk. And we're going to hit open. Okay. And then we're going to shrink this down. Now that we've shrunk it down, you can hit backspace and it will bring it up here. And all you're going to do is shrink it down until it's exactly the same size as the other one. We don't have to really do any measuring. Oop. Just a hair bigger. Nope. It's a little bit of tinkering, and if you're worried, you could always check it. So the width looks good. The height looks good. Alright, so let's do a smaller book. And it's literally the same process. 1, 2, 3. And go to pictures and it'll open up in the same folder. Let's see, smaller book. What the heck? Let's do a Goosebumps. I'm going to pick the Haunted Mask here. Okay. And we're going to shrink this down quite a bit. Just so that we can put it in line with the rest of the books. Now, a Goosebumps book is obviously going to be a small book. It's going to be significantly smaller. And I'm going to reach in my bucket and pull out one of the small ones. Come on. Alright, so, that's almost dead on. So, you can see the width is about right, and the height is about right. Just a hair more. I'm going to leave the width where it's at and just pull it down just another hair. And that should be about right. Perfect. So, I'm going to leave that as is. So, let's add one more. Since we don't have to use any books for measuring, but you can always double check everything. Alright, here's Celtic Myths and Legends. Or Frankenstein or Dracula. Just grab one here. So, I'm going to shrink this bad boy down. Boom. Boom. Bam. And then it's going to be the same size as the little guy there. Now, obviously, the width by pulling it by the corner is totally off. Now, I'm eyeballing it, but again, you can definitely double check it. And that looks about right. So I'm going to leave it. Now, the same thing with your pages. Let's see. So, I've got a big one here. And let me find a little open book. Just so I can show you. Okay, is this a little one? Yep. So, with your open books, and you want to do open pages, they're going to be the same. So, like with the big ones here, the D&D books, go in. And I should be able to find one of the D&D pages. Do 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 do. Do 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 do. Here we go. Magic items. Alright, so obviously that's way too big. Shrink the bad boy down. Alright, and then we're going to hit backspace, and then we're going to shrink this down to the same size as the book covers themselves. And you can see, if you shrink it down too far, see that little blue space up there? That tells me I shrunk it down past the level of those two books. So I can always bring it back up. Alright, and again, you can always double check it. Looks good to me. And then the same, just repeat the same process for the little book pages, only you're going to make them the same size as your book covers. So I think that's pretty self-explanatory. The same thing goes for scrolls and maps. So let me do a quick thing. So this is one of the spellbook covers. I've done this one before as a scroll, so I'll do it again. The water demon. Alright. So, we're going to go ahead and shrink this down so we can get it to the top of the page here. Boom. Alright. Now, we're going to shrink it so it's no wider than the D&D books is kind of a ruling that I set. It's about, I want to say it's close to 3/4 of a width of masking tape. It's not quite a full width. And so it might be a little bit bigger. Anyway, so it's a little distorted because it's way too tall. Then you just shrink that sucker down. Shrink it down. And there's no real size that I've set for myself. I just shrink it down. I do the width, and then I shrink it down till it gets kind of back in focus to where at least I can read the title of it, and the image isn't all warped and everything. And you can see from here, if I give you a little close-up shot, that looks pretty good. So I like that. So the scroll is going to be, you know, pretty accurately about that big. All right, let's do one map, which is going to be the same process. I'm going to jump down to the second line, just because maps have a very odd shape, and I want to make sure that I have plenty of room. And for this, I have to go into my map folder. There they are, D&D maps. Let's see, and I'm going to pull up the one that we just got off the internet. All right, so now we're going to shrink this down. And this is one of those things, I don't have like a specific measurement or anything. I'm just merely kind of winging it and judging it by eye. I know that the books are, you know, a said width, and the scrolls are said height. So I definitely don't want to go too big, but you could go big. I mean, if it's on a wall, if it's sprawled out on a floor, depending on the map, how much detail you want it to show. You can do it the entire size of the desk if you wanted. And you can play with various different sizes. So that, to me, looks about right. Maybe a hair bigger. And maybe I just want to pull this down a little bit. Just doing some adjusting here and there. That, to me, that looks good. Alright, so I'm going to get all my stuff done that I need for this particular project. And then we'll come back, we'll get this printed off, and we'll start adding it to our books. See you guys in a minute. Alright, so in a blink of an eye, actually it's been several hours. I went on kind of a crazy book cover hunt. And I also looked for some new pages because I had a couple ideas to use these books that I'm making for, since I've already got bookshelves and I've already got desks. Now you'll see here, there's three sets of the D&D books. That's because one set is going to be for a desk I'm making for DM Blair Wolf. The second set is one that I am making another desk because there happened to be some requests on the DM's Craft forum that I do a contest and give away one of my builds as a prize. So I'm going to give away a Game Master's desk as a prize. Don't know what the contest is going to be yet, but that's what we're going to do there. The third set here, there's not going to be a desk, but the gentleman, Velas, who sent me the crafting box, I am going to send him bag up a set for him. So he will get a set just without the desk, unfortunately. And then you'll see here, I've done two DM screens for the desk. It's the same premise. It's about four book widths wide, approximately, and one book height, and that's the D&D size books. The others are all small or normal size books. Let me give you a little close look here. So I've got some Goosebumps, I've got Aliens vs. Predator, I have Aliens, and this is the new series I'm currently reading, which is epic, so I highly recommend it to anyone else. You'll see some comic books, And then you'll see here I have the Necronomicon and the pages that go in it. So I'm also going to show you how to do the book that opens. That's also going to go to Veloz. As well as these scrolls here. So I did two different scrolls that I haven't done yet, and I'm going to show you how I make those. So now all we got to do is print this out, and then we'll move on to the next step. Okay, so I've got everything printed out here. Here's all the books, the Les Scrolls, and these are the maps that I had originally done. I went ahead and just printed it off so I could show you how to make one. But there we go. So your next step is going to be cut all this crap out. So I'm gonna get to it. All right, guys, so I've got everything laid out here. I've got my open book, the Necronomicon. We're gonna do that a little bit later. We're gonna start with the simple stuff, and then we'll move on to more complicated stuff, and then back into easy stuff. We'll do the scrolls and the maps last. We'll do the dungeon master screen, so I can make another one of those. So let's start. I've got my little container of books here, and let's start with one of the big ones, so it'd be really easy to see. Okay, so I have purple, so it matches the Dungeon Master's Guide, and you can see it fits on there very well. So then you're going to need your book cover and the mighty glue stick. That one's for you, AJ. And then you're just going to put the book cover on, smear it all around. You want to make sure that there's a nice even coat on the back side of the book cover. Then make sure you place it on the right direction, and ba-bam, you're gonna kick yourself for not thinking of this. And it's that easy. And you can get as crazy if you want to put a backing on this, the back of the book cover, absolutely go right ahead. I'm going to glue it down, so you're never going to see the backside, so there's no point in me going to that much more effort. But yeah, this is how you get some really cool books. Then you put them on your desk or shelf or whatever, and then when you clear coat them, it gives it a nice sealed look. Okay, guys, so you can see I have a giant pile of books over here. I have finished everything up. This is the extra DM books. The pile of random assorted stuff, comic books, which I think are going to be hysterical, and aliens, Tales from the Crib, Goosebumps, so a lot of good stuff, a lot of great feature books. Here's the other books for these desks. Oop, boom, sorry. So that's all done. So let's move on to making the DM screen. Just like this one here on the Game Master's desk. Okay. And I've already went ahead and did this one because I got to make two of them. So I'll just throw that one up there. And let's set the camera down. Give me just a minute to adjust here. There we go. All right. So. Wait. Oh, you fell. That's a blooper. Blooper. Alright, so let me put the camera down. See if I can get it steady, eddy, eddy here. There we go. Okay, guys, so what you're going to need is a strip of cardstock that is the same height as your DM screen. Okay, you'll also need a glue stick for this. Gotta be smarter than the glue stick. Okay. Alright, so you're first going to take, I always start with the front side of the DM screen, or the back side, depending on which way you look at it. player's standpoint of view, from DM's point of view. All right, there we go. And then you're going to jam it right onto the cardstock. Bam! Easy peasy lemon squeezy. All right, and I'm just going to line it up, you know, edge, and if it's a little off here, we'll just trim it. All right, so that's on. So let's get a little trimming. And it's kind of askew here, probably because I cut it crooked, you know. I'm a little crooked like that. There we go. All right, I could chuck this other piece over here, save that for another project. All right, so now, real easy, guys. All we're going to do is glue this to this. Again, easy peasy lemon squeezy. Now you can see that this is a little bit smaller than that cardboard. So what I'm going to do is look at the front and see where I can trim. Probably take it from the top because there's I don't want to cut out the people. So, and the dragon's got plenty of room. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to line it up with the bottom here and then one edge. And yeah, that edge. So let's get some your mighty glue stick and rub that right on there. Boom, 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 boom. And then make sure you put it the right way. You don't want it upside down or anything. All right, so this way. Although it wouldn't be that easily read, so it probably wouldn't matter with this piece. All right, so I'm just gonna trim that top. Just like that. Ba-boom. Now, we got to get it to bend just like the DM screen does. Okay? So, we're going to fold this right in half. And what I do is I just hold on to the middle and start pulling. And I don't want it to crease. I kind of want it to curve as I'm pulling. So this way I can get the ends to meet before that crease sets in. So I got like a teardrop right now. Both ends meet, and now we're going to make that crease. So got it in half. I gotta do a little trimming there. Bam! Okay. That's gonna be the new thing. You watch out, guys. Ba-bam! The crafting emerald. There we go. So then just kind of manipulate it, play with it, get your paper to line up properly. And it looks like I should have waited to trim that, but that's okay. I'll just trim it again. Should still be half and half. Yeah, pretty good. Okay. And then we're going to do the same thing and do it one more time, only because it's smaller, I got to push in this way. But we're going to touch in the middle. Do it nice and slow so there's a teardrop, and then just squeeze it down when you're ready. Bam. Squeeze it pretty tight, and you're going to see that it does that. That's where the manipulation comes in. You got to kind of mess with it there. And I'm going to wait to do any trimming until I'm done with the other side. Okay, so there's this one, and now we got to manipulate this one. Manipulate. Fold it. I don't know, manipulate's such a saucy word. So, and I'm not worried about that paper right there, because we'll fix it after. See? It just jumped over. I'm going to squish it down. And manipulate that paper. Again, waiting to trim till I get it situated. Ba-bam. And get it where I like it, which is going to be probably like that. So it's going to be quite open. Okay. And got to let the glue dry before I manipulate it anymore. So I'm just going to do the final trimmings. Ba-bam. There we go. So that's your DM screen. So we're going to throw that on this big guy back here. And now we're going to move on to... let's do the map. Here's our map printed out. Now you could essentially just leave it like this, which is perfectly fine. There's nothing wrong with that. You can glue it straight to whatever project you're working on. But I took it a little bit further. You're gonna need some masking tape. This is a really easy project. Super easy, and I'll show you why I do this too. So I'm just tearing off a piece of masking tape. I'm going to take the clean cut edge, and I'm going to overlap it just a little bit. Don't know if you guys can see that. I'll show you after. Let me just lay this down and use the factory edge along the bottom here. Boom, boom. And then press it down. Okay, so this is about one tape width wide. I have had ones where I've had to double up on the tape. So there's your tape, there's your map, and I've left this end here. Now, I'm not going to curl this one, but if you wanted to curl it, you could add, cut off a piece of this stick and then roll it right up. So that's how you would do it. And you'll get the idea, because I'm going to do similar to the scrolls. So I'm just going to trim the tape. Should I do the ba-bam again? Ba-bam! Trim that tape! Alright, so there you go. Now what this does is it strengthens the paper. And you can manipulate this to fold and stay in a position. You can undo that. Okay, so it's straight again. And let's say you want to just curl up one side. And what you can do is take a barbecue skewer and you roll it up. And because it's on the masking tape, it'll actually hold that shape for you without having to glue anything. And, if this was a loose piece, you could actually unroll it. Just another idea you could use there. And now that we've rolled it, we've kind of manipulated it, it's got this nice shape to it. But you can manipulate it to undo it. It's got kind of a nice used look here. And you can do anything. Now, if you wanted the two-sided roll, do the same thing. Like, it's just been rolled out. So manipulate that. And it will hold the shape with the masking tape. And that's why I like the masking tape. It's pretty awesome. So there. And then what I do when I have a map like this is I kind of warp it backwards. So it looks like it's been partially unrolled or unraveled. And it's got plenty of wave. So, now we're going to move on to the scrolls, okay? I have something about time loops, and this one is the Demon of Cruelty. I've already threatened my children that I've sold their souls to the devil, or a demon. You're going to need a piece of masking tape. I'm going to use this spare piece. And you can see that the scroll is not the same width as the masking tape, so it's slightly shorter. I would say, two-thirds of the tape? Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to lay this down on the edge of the tape. I hope you guys can see this. Again, I need to get one of those tripods. My oldest son's going to be helping me out on future vids, so he'll be my tripod and help video and stuff. Okay, There we go. All right, so we have that. And this is going to help us with the same thing with the maps and help us manipulate the paper. Now, if you're going to do this and you want to roll up the scroll, I'm going to show you how to do that. We're going to leave a little tag end down here. Oop, sorry about that. Again, no tripod. I cannot find the piece that I need. Aw, crap. Okay. Well, I forgot to leave my tag in on this one, so I'll do it on the next one, alright? Blooper! That's okay. So you can see I got the scroll. Again, it's the whole, you can manipulate it. So you can do something like this. You can take this and let's see, let's start up here. We're going to just give this a nice little curl because I want people to be able to read it. So you got that. And you can even take it like this. Roll it backwards. So you got this nice like S-curve scroll. Kind of like that, so I'm going to leave this one like that, but you can manipulate it any way you want. Look at that. Okay, now I'm going to have to get me another piece of tape. Another piece of tape, and we're going to do the same thing, but this time I'm going to leave a tag end on each end of this. Hope you guys can see. Here we go. Bam! Alright, so, tag end. You don't need a whole lot, but you want some. Okay. Trim up this one, again, leaving the tag end. Sorry. Off frame there. Trimming the scroll a little bit. There, so it's nice and scrolly. Alright, now we're going to need two pieces of barbecue skewer, or you could do one if you only had one tag in. The same width as your scroll there. So I'm just going to mark it with the scissors. And then give me a second here. I'm going to cut it off camera because it's easier. Whoa, that one cut pretty easy. And then, I'm going to measure that with this piece. So all I'm doing is really simply holding it like that. And then I'm just going to cut me off another one. There we go. And the chopstick went flying. All right. Oh, Zoe's going to get it for me. Oh, Sammy, thank you guys. And then, so you stick it on, and then you just roll it up. It's that easy. And done. Take this one. Do the same thing. Roll it up. Now, you can glue them into place. I don't feel it necessary. The masking tape tends to hold them pretty good. And then I'm just going to put some more curves in this. Kind of like that. And you can roll this up as much as you want. So you can, I mean, really, it depends on how much you want to show of the scroll. So the choice is up to you. But you can leave it like that. I like that it's kind of open-ish. And then, of course, if you glue it down to a table or a desk or a bookshelf, you know, that's kind of what you got going on there. So that's really easy, and you don't have to paint them because the tape actually matches and it looks good. All right, so for our last project in this, we are going to make the Necronomicon. You're going to need a strip of cardboard that is the same height as your book covers. Okay. And you can make any kind of open book you want. So it doesn't have to be a Necronomicon. But I love the Evil Dead movies, and with the Evil Dead versus Ash TV show coming out, I had to make one. So, strip of cardboard. You're going to need your glue stick, and we're going to need some hot glue. So get your hot glue heated up, and let's get going. All right, so first thing we're going to do is we're going to pick out which pages we want for the inside of the booklet. So on the opposite side of the book here. So I'm going to go with, I want this one to be on the front. This one to be on the back page. So this will be your first page. This will be your last page. Okay. So the rest are part of your book. So I got 2, 2, and 2. So what you're going to do is you're going to take them and glue them together. Ba-bam. Okay. So there. And then make sure you put them the right way. And get them lined up there. Now, if it overlaps a little bit, just push it more towards the side where the spine will go. Because that's going to get hot glued in and no one's ever going to see it. Now that we have our book pages, don't glue them, but stack them together. So we're going to need to use them in just a moment to measure how thick the spine will be. Okay, so those are stacked together. So take your front cover of your book. Get some glue on that bad boy. Okay. And then stick it right there. Ba-bam. Shazam. There we go. Alright, so, and what I meant by measuring is we're just going to take the pages stacked together and just kind of eyeball, you know, so we want to leave just a slight little gap. Sorry. Whoop. So line it up right here and just kind of mark. I mean, it's not that big, so I'm going to leave just a slight little gap because I got to make sure that the pages will fit in when it's folded over. So I'll show you now. You take your back cover, load it up with glue, ba-bam. Then, sorry, I can't help myself sometimes. I do have ADHD. All right. So see, I left a slight gap for the spine, and that's so that when you bend it, you'll be able to fit the pages in. Okay, so then we're going to cut this off. And now we have a book with the front and back. And now we're going to glue the inside first and last pages. Alright guys, so I've got the book, I've got my hot glue gun all heated up and ready to rock and roll. And let's put this bad boy together. So when you hold your pages, again, I'm just going to remind you, any white edges or anything that's overlapping, that's going to be your spine part. And put them in the order that you want them in. So basically you're ready to go with those. And I'm going to put those right here. Grab your book, make sure you're holding it the proper way. Okay, now I'm just going to run a small tiny bead right down the center. My hot glue gun is nice and hot. Okay, now take your pages. Boom, boom. You want to try to do this as fast as possible. Get them set right in the center of that glue. Okay? And then another thing I like to do is go ahead and kind of spread them before the glue dries. Okay? make any adjustments that you need. I will have to trim that one up. It's showing a little too much white there. All right. So give that a little bit of time to dry. Doesn't take long. You can see the glue right down there in the corner hasn't quite clouded up yet, so it's still wet. It's getting there. But I mean, you can leave it like this and you can still, you know, look through the pages. Or what I like to do sometimes is take it and then just give it a pinch. And it, I don't know, it just kind of helps bring it a little closer together. So looks like that first page is quite big. And it's okay if they stick out a little bit, but that's quite a bit. So I'm just going to trim that up. And then I'm just going to trim this page down slightly. Try to do it on camera if I can remember. And there. It's about right. Trim a little bit of the top. Just a little off the top, please. And then just a tiny bit on the bottom. And we should be all right. And you can play with this and adjust it however you like it. You don't have to be this picky. You could have left it. I mean, the original Necronomicon was kind of a sloppy, almost thrown together kind of look to it. So, all right, there you go. Now, some of you may be curious, well, what do you do with the spine? Paint it, or do like I do? Use a Sharpie! All right, so to deal with this spine here, I make it nice and easy. Just take a Sharpie and color in the back of it. There you go all the way down. And that's it, that's that easy. Now, if you want to, you could go around the edges of the book if you want to. I don't feel it's necessary. I think it kind of, it looks like old anyway. So I just wanted to cover that up so it matched the cover. And that's how you do an open book that you could potentially read. I mean, if I could read lettering that small. But just a cool little thing, you know, people like that. First of all, they're going to recognize it from the cover and go, oh my God, this is Necronomicon. Ooh, look, I can see the pages. Oh yeah, I recognize that from the movie. Oh my God. You know, so really cool. And so this is going to go in this pile that's going to Velos. And then, so what do you do from here? Well, you can glue them into book cases. This one is showing some here and here. Now these are board games. You can do this. All I did was glue the cover of the board game to a piece of popsicle stick. But you kind of get the idea, you know? Just stick them in there so it's like little Easter eggs. Which you can do if you got people that have certain books that they love, throw them on there. Get them excited. They're going to look at that piece and go, oh my God, that's my favorite book of all time. You know? So, you know, open books, you can glue out like that. The one on top there. Just like somebody took it out and didn't feel like putting it back, so they just threw it on top. This one. So all these books are full, except for the... or facing one direction except for the one up here, you know, where you can see. So it's a special hidden one. I did this one for my littlest son because he's a huge Star Wars fan. And then the maps and scrolls. And this is without painting them. And this went really, really wicked fast. So this is really fast and easy to do. And I got open, I've got closed. This one here is a dot of hot glue. And just paint that red. Simple as that. Or you can make a nice little desk. You don't have to put a base on it, but because this is a special Gaming Master's desk, I did put a base on it. And I have you know, glued it, hot glued everything to it, and real simple, real easy to do. Stacked them up, but I stacked them up kind of cuck-eyed so you can see it. So I've got two of these to glue together, and then I'm going to take these little black bases and make book piles, okay? And what I'm going to do is I'm going to pile up a bunch of these books. Okay, I'm going to glue these on. Then take a couple of the feature books and just stick them in the pile so that when they look at it, it's not so random. I mean, you'll have something to actually look at. Now, if your characters are on a quest for a specific book, maybe you could kind of wedge it in here and they can actually pick up the pile and look for it. Maybe there's a hidden gem in between these books here. And if they pick up the pile and actually physically search it, I mean, it's just another gaming element you could possibly throw in there. But look at these. Those look great. Alien. Now, this is the Out of Shadows one that I am currently reading from the new series. And this is, I believe this one's River of Pain, I think. Let me double check, see if I can actually read that. Sea of Sorrows. And then the other one is River of Pain. And then you have Tales from the Crypt. And even though I had to trim these, okay, I did trim a little bit off the bottom. You can still tell. I mean, those are Tales from the Crypt. Spider-Man comic book. Come on, focus. Focus. Trying to get it to focus. Focus. There we go. So you guys can see that. It's the Spider-Man comic book. The open books. This one here is Alien. I'm not obsessed with Alien at all. Okay. And then this comic book here is Batman. Some pages out of a Batman. So, looking good. If I can get the camera to focus on it. And come on. Alright, I don't think it's going to focus on this one, but you get the idea. Then, you know, I've got other things going on. I showed you guys how to make the maps, the scrolls, the different types of scrolls. So, I'm going to glue everything together and show you what things look like in the end. Alright? Alright guys, so I am done all but sealing, which I don't think you guys need to see me do. I use a water-based polycrylic protective varnish, crystal clear finish, ultra-fast drying, easy water cleanup, best stuff I've ever used. Now, if you don't have this, you can simply brush over everything with a light coat of Elmer's glue, and that'll seal everything and protect it. So I haven't done that, but I don't think you guys need to see me do that. So you guys can make books for friends. Okay, I'm shipping this off to Velas. He had sent me one of the crafting boxes, so he gets a pack which has got the two scrolls that we just made, the map, the open Necronomicon, and the DM books. Okay, and then like I said, the other thing that you can do if you've already got full bookshelves, you make book piles. And you can see here, I've hidden a little gem inside. And you can see how those titles just kind of pop out, and they're fun and exciting. And again, it just adds interest to it, you know. People will want to pick these up. It makes it interactive. I think that's the word I was looking for earlier, was interactive. But totally a lot of fun. Easy to build, easy to make. And so now I have book piles to make my library even more of a mess. The comic books that I have here are going to be for another project that's up and coming. This little book about Diablo here is, I'm going to make a little pedestal stand for it, just to have something different. And then I have all these extra books to do other things with. So if I ever make another shelf or who knows what. But yeah, that's it. I hope you guys like this tutorial. I apologize if it's a little long. I think this is the third tutorial that I've ever made on my channel. So I hope you guys enjoy, and I'll see you next time.